So, hey, what is up? It's your boy Adi. Today we are talking about none other than our one and only Intel. So, they have finally laid out their roadmap for the upcoming 2 or 3 years, and they have some great plans. So, we're talking about this today. Intel has provided some new details on its upcoming CPU roadmap during its 2022 Investor Day presentation. We already know a few things like Intel's 13th generation Raptor Lake processors. They are set to be released in the second half of 2022, and it's clear they are in a good state this far out. As Intel demonstrated a working system with a Raptor Lake CPU processor, it's said to be an evolutionary upgrade over 12th generation Alder Lake processors. Don't you guys think that evolutionary is a misused word in every terms of the world? Whatever every company is using them here and there, evolutionary this, evolutionary that, evolutionary what the fuck. It will include up to 8 updated P cores and 16 updated E cores, double the count of the 12900K. Jim Johnson, senior vice president and the interim leader of the client computing group, said that Intel is targeting a double digit performance boost compared to existing 12th generation processors. Intel also teased some new overclocking enhancements, and although we long suspected it, it's confirmed that 13th generation processors will be compatible with existing 12th gen motherboards. Finally, some backwards compatibility for the motherboards. Perhaps the most interesting part of the Raptor Lake update was the reveal of an AI accelerator in an M.2 form factor. It may not have much use for gamers, and then Nvidia has support for its Tensor cores, which include AI functionality. Could such an accelerator be used in a similar way? Could it be? Time will tell. Big changes are set to come in the following Meteor Lake generation. These will presumably be called 14th generation processors and are currently scheduled to launch sometime in 2023. Meteor Lake is set to include a tile or a chiplet based architecture with multiple dies on the same package. The CPU tile is said to be fabricated on Intel's next generation Intel 4 node. As the design is highly modular, Intel can chop and change different tiles depending on its use case. Intel could add a better Arc GPU or limit an AI accelerator depending on the market segment. How about 15th and 16th generation processors? Intel is hard at work developing them too. The first of these is codenamed Arrow Lake. It's currently scheduled to replace Meteor Lake in 2024. Long term plans, huh? Intel, you cheeky bastard. It's said to be produced using Intel's 20A node. It may be that Arrow Lake is another evolutionary upgrade, again evolutionary this, evolutionary that, whatever companies just keep using this word evolutionary. So it may be that Arrow Lake is another evolutionary upgrade following the major changes introduced in the Meteor Lake generations. Is TikTok bad? Then there's Lunar Lake, which may come as early as 2024, and it looks as though it will coexist with Arrow Lake. Intel mentioned that it aims to reclaim performance per watt leadership with Lunar Lake, and given it stated that it's an ultra low power design, it means it's most likely a mobile architecture. Who knows? Maybe with its tile based architecture, adding an ARM tile isn't outside the realm of possibility. After years of 14 nanometer and Skylake plus memes, Intel has clearly shifted gears. Finally, Intel has become Luffy.
भाई सब कुछ ज़्यादा नहीं हो गया ये. मतलब कुछ भी.
Its process technology and the roadmap look to be very aggressive. Its CPU roadmap, advanced packaging technologies, and developing graphics IP mean Intel is well placed to take on AMD in the years ahead. Jane, AMD legend is coming back to dethrone you. Be prepared, AMD, be prepared. Legends are coming back. Sorry for being dramatic, sorry. Hey, if you guys like the content and want to watch more of my nonsense, please drop the like and subscribe and press the bell notification button and do whatever you like. Tada! Jane!